WRIF, nonstop rock and roll.
Rocking Detroit since 1971.
Detroit's rock station, 101 WRIF, everything that rocks. Jade here, we're celebrating the 50th anniversary of 101 WRIF. And now joining us, we got to make some noise for the one and only Ken Calvert. And we do have JJ and George still joining us. So,
what are you looking at, Bruiser?
Yeah. The Calvert, this is fair warning.
There it is.
You remember that, Kenny
oh,
boy?
Oh, my God, do yeah. I remember that. And I was thinking about a couple of things. Did you ever get a hold of Eli?
I did. Eli's on the road driving his car around, but because of social distancing rules, I couldn't make that happen. But
well, you can't afford that.
He's out salting the roads.
What did you pay for that house, Calvert? You can't afford
that. You can't afford that, Calvert.
Man, we had some good
times. Well, do you want Eli in here with COVID, by the way? Because that's Eli.
That's Eli. Always has
I've
been.
Met so him. I've
why,
met
okay,
him.
Why would a guy who sounds like that clear his voice before going on the air? I don't know.
He always walked into the room like there was food. Did you ever notice that? He was always...
That's probably why he's not here, because he heard there wasn't. He was the guy. Right. He was the guy at WRIF Management issued a memo about people pilfering other people's lunches.
That's right.
From the kitchenette refrigerator.
That's right.
And it was written about Eli. It didn't have his name in it.
And how long ago do you think that was?
It had to be early 80s. Or 80.
Yeah. Early 80s, yeah.
So we still have that problem in 2021. Yeah. So that hasn't changed.
By the way,
every company has an Eli within it, but he was the Eli.
Do you have any Viagra for your boom here? That's just the...
personal question, Jim.
That is one way to put it. I'll see if we can get Ron. We can get somebody to...
I don't
to,
know if this is a good to, time to invite to Ken.
Is this where you got the string in your last name?
Yeah. Yes, that's the
you
spring
took it
of my
from
last
the mic
name.
Boom.
So we do, via remote technology, remote satellite, we do have Karen Savelly on the phone with us. Karen, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
Karen Savelly, I love your belly.
The First Lady of Rock and Roll.
First Lady of Rock and Roll.
Karen, thank you so much for being here with us. How you doing out there?
Well, thanks for having me. Good.
How you doing, boom?
Hanging
boom.
In there.
How you doing? We're just reminiscing. Real quickly, what's the first thing that comes to mind? I mean, that's a tough one, but what's
these days, the men's room. Sorry. It's been a long time.
I think
you
meant when you think about RIF.
Do you have any...
The trailers.
Is there any... Yeah. Oh, the trailers. Were
that's the
greatest.
First thing, because that was the first experience we had with this place. Where
we have
trailers.
A photo of the trailers right behind you there.
Oh, yes, you do. Look at that.
Do you remember when they...
Nope.
When the guy would cut the lawn, the guy in the big tractor, and he'd have the window open. We didn't have air conditioning. I swear, well, we had a room air conditioner that was louder than heck.
But we had a great-looking lawn.
Oh, we did.
Yeah. Karen...
Yeah. Yeah.
Karen, what do you remember? What's the first thing that pops
what do you
into
think
your
about
mind?
It?
Well, you know, it's funny. I got some old pictures out, and I have a photograph of me interviewing Rush, and we are in the trailers, and I think that it is going to be sent over to you so you guys can take a look at it.
Oh, wow. All right.
Oh, that would be fantastic.
And I also remember that you had to be careful when you walked in the studio or the records would skip.
Yes. Yes. It was a trailer.
Yeah.
And the floor went like that, like all trailers.
And do you guys remember we also had to hit... we were ABC, and we had to hit the news at the top of the hour.
Mm-hmm.
And it was live. And you'd get a 10-second tone before it would come down the line.
We screwed that up every time. But back to the trailer window, I don't know if you remember, our first week there, it was hot in that room. We slid open that door, and sure enough, as soon as we go on the air, the guy in the riding tractor goes by, and our boss calls Tom Benner at the time. Yeah. Went crazy. And then a few minutes later, I made the mistake. We needed an extra record, right?
So I know where this one's going.
Yeah, I grabbed an album off the studio shelf. It was Slowhand, Eric Clapton, right? So, okay, cool. Oh, look at our first week there, literally, here. And I pulled the album out, put it down. I said, throw Cocaine on. That's the number one song off this album. Oh, man, that hotline lit up like a Christmas tree.
Where did that come from?
And me being the smartass that I am, I said, that's from Slowhand, Tom. Because apparently, as ABC was our parent company, they had banned that song, thinking it was promoting cocaine when it was doing exactly the opposite.
Right.
But they weren't taking that for an answer.
Well, yeah. So I've listened to all the episodes of the History of Riff podcast, which, of course, is available online, WRIF.com, on iTunes and Google Play. But all of you who were there in the early days have a story about the trailers. And mm-hmm. I wish so badly that I could just be a fly on the wall and have been there and seen just some of the hilarious things that I can only imagine you guys have gone through with the window and the air conditioning and the skipping of the records.
When we moved from the trailers into that brand new building, which was unlike anything anybody had ever seen
before.
We
mentioned that earlier, the best.
We had ever seen. The worst to the first.
Best.
I mean, it was unbelievable. And they had a massive party. The president of ABC came in. Kelly Harmon came in because she was doing the remarkable...
The lips commercial.
Yeah, the remarkable mouth spot. And I got a great picture of you standing right next to her with me interviewing her. And George, you were tidying up the studio as this was all going on.
I have
on.
The same one.
Isn't that a great shot?
It is.
It's a great shot.
Did I have my maid's outfit on?
We all got a little overserved at the party.
Yeah.
You guys know.
So Johnson commandeers the tractor with commandeers a tractor.
Oh, wait. Okay. It's ABC and it's the Channel 7 studios.
That's right.
And there's a barn in the back of the property with all the implements because we had farmland there. People, employees could go grow vegetables.
So, Johnson, I don't know if you did it with a paperclip or what he said, but I can start anything.
Yeah.
Johnson says I can start anything.
I thought you were talking about something else with a paperclip because I do know, and not that I.
But I just want to say real quickly.
They all went back and got back to nature. Yeah, on that one.
What I was going to say is we all went around. You put us all in the back of a cart.
Yeah.
And we drove around.
It was a hayride.
Yeah, he took us on a hayride back through the woods.
I jump-started the tractor.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. We were singing 99 miles around the wall. Yeah.
The Riff Rockin' Hayride. I can only imagine.
True story.
And the paper fun clip that you guys
came in
handy.
The paper clip.
Came in handy.
Unbelievable. Come in. Real handy.
Well, we've had a ton of listeners all week because we've been doing this week-long celebration, and today is, kind of the big day, and then, of course, Sunday is the actual anniversary, so we've got a ton of stuff going on all weekend, but just so many people texting in and remembering the old days, whether it's with Ken or the Tigers, JJ and the Morning Crew, Costa and Arthur Penhallow, and so, of course, we got to thank the listeners for being there. What are some of your favorite memories of listeners?
Karen.
Is she there?
Karen.
There she is.
Yes, I am.
It's an unfortunate name in 2021, but go ahead, Karen.
Well, we answered the phones, by the way. Every time we would take a call, they'd go, what does Karen Savelly look like? Does she look like what I think she does? And I'd go, yes, she does.
The original Riff rock girl.
Well, absolutely. I mean, Karen is a role model for women in the entertainment industry.
An icon.
Wow. And an inspiration. And so... what are some of your favorite memories just over the years with these hooligans? I mean, you guys are the smiles on your faces. I hope that, Karen, you feel the same way. Like, what an honor to have you here, Karen. What's some of the memories?
Well, thank you. The ones I can remember.
so many memories.
No, it was great. I just remember when Jay Hoker brought, JJ and the Morning Crew and Ken and myself over to Riff. In, what was it, 1979?
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Yes, it was.
I was living in Chicago.
Yeah.
And
that was so
and
cool.
I was working
and
for
you know,
Columbia
you were
Records,
you were mentioning when we went into the new building, what I remember was that I got to meet all the personalities from Channel 7.
Oh, I know. Oh, yeah.
I thought it was awesome.
You know what? That's a great thing. I'm glad you brought that up because anytime we would have a party, those guys would all come over. I remember all of
them. Yep. Well, yeah, Bill Bonds.
What a cool guy. What a great
cocktail hour. Here's the reason for it. It was owned by ABC, and that was back at a time when they spared no expense for everything. So if the sales staff at the radio station or the TV station threw a party, it was for everybody. It was all the premium booze, all the food you could eat. I think people even stuck full bottles of vodka into their coats to take home.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I remember I was at the shrimp boat with Tom Gerrell from ABC Nightly News. They were in for the Republican National Convention.
1980.
And they had the biggest tent I've ever seen out on the lawn. And they had a massive party. And we had to dress to impress, they told us. So I'm at the shrimp boat and I got kind of tangled up with these two shrimp that wouldn't separate. And I flicked it. And this big shrimp landed right on top of Tom Zero's $400 loafers back then.
Oh, no.
He just looked at me and I went to reach down. He went, no. No. No.
He looked at you and said, FM radio station. Right?
Yeah, yes, Mr. Gerald. It's very nice to meet you.
I'm sorry. But, Karen, I'm sorry. You bring up these highlights.
You know what? I'm used to this.
Wait a minute, though. Hold on, Karen. Tell the truth. You know, you were one of the very few, and certainly the first when it came to being the queen of rock on the radio. And I think, honestly, remembering back, you know, we're a bunch of big mouth guys that came in there, but I think we treated you with respect. I don't think we ever bullied
Absolutely.
You. I think you were always our equal, no matter what.
And always over-prepared to a fault.
Yep.
You would carry in stacks and stacks and stacks of
I got in trouble for that a few times.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
I can imagine, though, dealing with you guys, if she's got this riffraff hanging out with her, somebody's got to be prepared in the group, right?
No, that's true, too.
One of the program directors called me compartmentalized.
Oh, really? Well, at the annual review?
You always find that a program director has something to say, and, what are you going to do?
Let it go in one ear and out the other. Things haven't changed. Curl your hair with some stories.
I bet you can.
Remember when we stole the Riff van and drove it down to Daytona Beach?
Oh, jeez.
Well, we didn't steal it. That was approved.
Well, it was, but on the air, it was playtime, George. This is radio.
What was not approved?
The Wizard of Oz?
What was not approved was when the fan down there saw us on the beach. Hey, it's JJ. And then he slipped in the sand and boom. He dented
head first right into the side of the
he dented the right front door of the Riff van.
But early morning, just last quick story about that. Early morning, we're doing our show live, and there was a bunch of fans because we encouraged them to come on down, right? And there's a couple who'd probably been there all night laying in the sand under a blanket sleeping. They were just waking up, and as would happen sometimes when two people in love wake up, there's...
Oh, boy.
There was a little action.
Yeah. But we couldn't see their faces. We couldn't see their... They were all covered under the blanket, but we knew what they were doing. Oh. So we went over there and did a live play-by-play.
Sure. Because why not?
I think we had Howard Cosell on, too. He could go all the way.
And, man, the phone line, it was Fred Jacobs, who has been a consultant for this station. And at the time, he was our program director. I mean, literally, by the time we walked 15 feet back to the van, our little in-van hotline was ringing. And he lit us up. And I said... I'm sorry, you know, I think we're on the beach. I got a bad connection. I can't hear a word you're saying, Fred.
Well, on that note, we're going to take a quick break. We have Bob Seger calling in and joining us. We're also going to talk to Alice Cooper. So thank you guys so much.
Cooper.
Once again, Ken Calvert, Karen Savelly. JJ and the morning crew.
Kenny Boy, always a pleasure. Love you.
Celebrating our 50th anniversary presented by Bud Light when you really want your favorite beer. There's a Bud Light there, WRIF. WRIF HD1, Detroit.
WRIF, Detroit's home of rock and roll. Locks you in your car, at work, at home. WRIF.
Celebrating 50 years in Detroit Rock City.